in the House.
And David, in the bigger picture, did Congressman Wilson's actions embolden Republicans who are fighting to defeat health care reform, or some are fighting to defeat it? Congressman Steve King, Republican of Iowa, has circulated a letter to fellow House Republicans urging them to come to Wilson's defense. And in part, it reads, quote, "We urge that you hold your ground against those who seek partisan advantage and reject all demands for additional redress. Like you, we will not be muzzled." And joining us live from Capitol Hill is the author of that letter, Congressman Stephen King, Republican of Iowa. Congressman, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
So what is the core of your argument as to why Congressman Wilson should not apologize to the members of Congress, not the White House, not Rahm Emanuel, not President Obama, but the members of Congress?
Well, the central piece of this is that it was the president that was speaking. It's the president's speech that was interrupted. It was the president speaking through the chief of staff, which one does when they're a member of Congress talking to the White House. It was the president who accepted the apology. And so if it's good enough for President Obama, and clearly he had his opportunity on 60 Minutes last night to call for an additional apology, he did not, then no one else has a claim to an additional apology. That's the central of the argument. And Joe Wilson is the consummate Southern gentleman, an officer and a gentleman. And everybody in the House of Representatives knows it.
Well, Congressman, let's just suppose then it was not the president who was speaking. Suppose it's a floor speech that you're giving and somebody in the other party interrupts you. Is the damage just to you, or is the damage to the institution itself?
They will say it's a damage to the institution. I think it does, though. It erodes the decorum of the institution. By the way, I've had Democrats interrupt me many times on the floor of the House of Representatives, and we have the business of this country to move forward on. I haven't even moved to take their words down when that's happened. So this thing needs to be put away. We've got a country to run. We shouldn't be mired in this.
Fair point, but Congressman, given that the Republican leadership, they were the ones who suggested that Congressman Wilson apologize on the House floor, wouldn't we have been able to move beyond this had Congressman Wilson followed their advice last week and simply gone to the well and say the same thing that he said to Rahm Emanuel?
Well, I would stand with Joe Wilson on this. I think the apology went to the right place. It went at the right time, as quickly as he could get off the floor and pick up the phone and call the White House. I understand he made that apology. And to drag this out any further, or to put Congressman Joe Wilson, this officer and gentleman, on a national contrition tour like Trent Lott went on, would be a huge mistake for the country. It'd be a mistake for Democrats to bring it up, as a matter of fact.
Congressman, in your letter that you sent out, you also said that you had heard the president declare prominent politicians to be liars in his speech for disagreeing with him on health care. And the president, was pointing out what he says were myths about the proposals out there. But if I can recall, he didn't say that there were liars amongst prominent politicians. And that's what you wrote in your letter.
No, I could say he said prominent politicians, they are lies, plain and simple. And he was speaking specifically about the end-of-life panels.
Right.
And he immediately followed with those who disagreed with him on whether the health care proposal would fund illegals. And Joe Wilson knows, as I know, that there were two committee votes that blocked out any kind of certification process for citizenship, and that also the Congressional Budget Office and the Congressional Research Services have all concurred with Joe Wilson and myself that the bill that passed out of committee in the House would fund illegals, and there are dollar figures we can look at.
Well, Congressman, just to be absolutely clear, let's go ahead and cite what is in three of the bills that did pass Congress. It says specifically, nothing in this subtitle shall allow federal payments for affordability credits on behalf of individuals who are not lawfully present in the United States. It seems pretty clear to most people that that means that illegal immigrants cannot get any benefits.
I would point out that the first bill that came to the floor, the omnibus spending bill, that the chairman of the appropriations bill, David Obey, managed when they had all pledged there would be no earmarks in the bill. David Obey read a similar piece of language in the first paragraph that said nothing in this, that there are no earmarks in the bill. But president signed over 5,000 earmarks in a bill, and just because that language is there, there's no provisions to keep the funding from illegals. We had that language. It was in the Medicaid provisions, and it was taken out under the S-CHIP legislation. We proposed to put it back in this health care bill. It was voted down 29-28 in the Energy and Commerce Committee, and voted down on a party line in the Ways and Means Committee. Democrats know what they're doing. They want to fund illegals, and this is just simply a red herring.
Congressman Steve King of Iowa, thank you very much for your time today, sir. And David, I suspect this continues for the main reason is both sides are benefiting. You